Hello, hello. Kenny Evans here, another car video. Topic of this video is Steph and Ayesha Curry are in an open relationship. Allegedly. So, before I get into the video, I gotta let y'all know this channel is not just about dating relationships, though it's the main thing we have been talking about thus far. It's also about health, wealth, and mindset as well, because I want you, both you men and women, to be the best you can be in all aspects of your life. I want you to be a complete person. So that is what this is all about. And again, this channel is for you guys, not me. I'm creating the videos, but it's to help you guys be the best you can be in all aspects of your life. So now we got that out of the way. You know, I know we got some new people, welcome. I know we got some returning people, welcome. For both who haven't already, subscribe, hit that notification button so you're notified for whenever I make some new videos. And if you like the video, if you just want to support me, hit that like button. You know, I appreciate it. You know what I mean? Let's help this video spread a little bit. You know, so let's get back to the topic at hand. Steph and Ayesha Curry are in an open relationship, allegedly. And so it's pretty interesting, you know, because it's, Steph and Ayesha Curry were the Black Love Goals. Now you still got Russ and Sierra. But Steph and Ayesha were more traditional because Ayesha was, quote unquote, a regular girl. You know, Sierra was a celebrity. You know, Sierra kind of had her ways and then she settled down. But Ayesha was just a regular girl. Steph, you know what I mean? He's a celebrity, but he seemed very clean cut. You know what I mean? They seemed like the perfect Black modern marriage, traditional. Traditional marriage, more traditional in modern times marriage with Black people. So Black people specifically looked to them as the marriage goals, you know what I mean? But yeah, a lot of people I'm sure are shocked by this. And again, it's allegedly, you know, we don't have any real proof yet, but I'm sure as things start, going along and coming out, it'll be a little bit more concrete. But yeah, and I'm sure a lot of people are shocked about this, especially Black people, you know what I mean? So that's the main thing, and the reason this is such a big deal, you know, because they were such a quote unquote perfect Black couple, you know what I mean? So I'm gonna tell you the reasons this is such a big deal and the impact it's gonna have. First and foremost, we should have saw this coming or something down the line. And a lot of people did. If you watch YouTube after this thing actually happened, Ayesha went on Jada Pinkett Smith's show last year saying she wanted more attention from men. First and foremost, Jada Pinkett Smith is in an open relationship. And then second, Ayesha is saying that she wanted more attention from men. I mean, you can't really do that, you know, being in a monogamous relationship. Sure, you could post online, but the attention that you get is cool. Because if you see Ayesha Curry this past year, and even up until this year, she got in great shape. She was always a beautiful girl, but now she got her body right. You know what I mean? She got her body looking good, so you know she's getting even more attention. But usually people who are in shape, and they feel good about themselves, they like the attention, but just getting the attention, compliments, it gets old. You know what I mean? You want more. You know, you want to actually have sex with other people who you find attractive, because biologically, if you look good, you're gonna attract a very attractive person physically. You know, and it's hard, especially if you find that person attractive, they cool, you want to get it in. You know what I mean? It's just kind of natural. You know, and it's like monogamy, you think about it, but when you're getting thrown here, there, and Ayesha, I'm sure she's been thrown. She used to just get compliments, and I'm sure now she's getting hit on because she's looking so good. You know what I mean? And when you get all those opportunities, it's hard to resist, especially if you like what you see. You know, and that was just a huge starting point. Her going on that show, David Pinkett Smith's show, and saying that she wanted more attention from men. A huge red flag went up in a lot of people's eyes. And especially now that more people know that Jada Pinkett Smith is in an open relationship. You know what I mean? And then on top of that, Steph's mom cheated. I mean, all that adds up, man. It really does. And these are older, you know, older women than Ayesha, who she looks, especially Steph's mom, they were close, you know. So, I mean, it's a big deal, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's the first thing. Second, more celebrities are gonna start coming out and doing open relationships, especially since Will and Jada opened up about theirs, if they aren't already, just because it's something that naturally, especially if you men and women, you have opportunities to get sex with all these different people. What's to stop you? You know what I mean? Especially if you want to get married, but it's like I also want to have all these options. Having sex with one person for the rest of your life, it's tough. It's tough, believe it or not, it's tough. All the relationships you may see who look happy for 20, 50, 30 years. You don't know that some of them might have. You know, Lucario went over this. He brought this out. You don't know that some of these people might have been sleeping around. Maybe they have an arrangement where they have a mistress on the side. Maybe they even had a secret family. But you just know about the monogamous relationship that they're in. But you don't know all the stuff that might be going on behind the closed doors. You know what I mean? So celebrities, especially when they, again, they have the access to all these different people, some of which they will find sexually attractive and they're going to want to take advantage of. You know what I mean? So it's just, you got to understand, it's easier for them to do it. Be married, monogamous in the public eye, behind closed doors, they do what they want. Yeah. Thirdly, depending on who actually wanted to do the open relationship, their relationship may be in trouble. And again, I know Mr. Lucario touched on this too, but just naturally. Because if Ayesha wanted it, if she wanted the open relationship, the relationship is doomed. Because it shows she is not following Steph's lead, one, and it shows he's not enough for her, two. And again, when you have access, we get it. But at the same time, you would think his looks, money, and status would have been enough for her. But naturally, over time, they've known each other for, damn, most of their lives. They've been married for 10 years now. It gets old. And you can imagine Steph, he's a professional athlete, he's always on the road. He probably gets his opportunities. You know what I mean? He probably gets a lot of opportunities, and she's at the house. But now, sure, she's getting a lot more opportunities. I'm sure she's going out and she gets hit on, and again, she's gets hit on by guys that she likes sexually. And you just never know, man. She wanted to give in, and she was just like, "Hey, I gotta do this, man, or I gotta go." And again, depending, I don't know. It might have been Steph, but I don't see what he would gain. He probably has all the opportunities. You know what I mean? And he might have turned them down. We don't know. Or maybe he's already been pursuing. And now Ayesha's like, "Hey, you already doing your thing. I want to be able to get to do my thing." You know what I mean? We're not going to do it behind closed doors. Not going to make it public. We'll be a united front to the camera. But behind closed doors, she wants to do it. She wants to do her own thing. I don't know. It's all speculation. All this is alleged. They might not be in an open relationship. I don't know. But lot of reports are coming out about it. So just depending, you know, because if she wants it, next step is just going out. You know what I mean? Because eventually maybe she finds somebody else. And she, instead of wanting to stay with Steph, maybe she wants to get another boyfriend, or, you know what I mean? You never know. You just never know all the crazy stuff that could be happening with them. So, yeah, the last but not least reason this is a pretty big deal is because, naturally, believe it or not, you may think this is crazy, but believe it or not, monogamy is not natural. I kind of mentioned a little bit throughout this video, but monogamy is not natural. The whole reasons initially they, you know, society started monogamy because women were having kids left and right, and it was the village who was taking care of the kids. So they wanted to be able to decide or figure out who was the father. So they decided, hey, you got to be with this man so you guys can have kids. And, you know, then you guys will know who your children are and who your line is. Instead of just having kids everywhere and everybody got to take care of the kids when it's not their responsibilities. Secondarily, I believe is because of business. Because as you had families that did establish a wealth, they wanted to mix with other families so their kids would be able to carry on that legacy. But initially, it was so women in the village society would be able to know whose kids belong to which man. You know what I mean? Because that's what it was. Everybody was just out having sex. They, you know, fucking and sucking everybody out here. Men, women were just doing their own thing, having fun, as long gathering food, surviving. You know what I mean? Monogamy was to figure out whose kids were who, and to build business relationships between families and have that build on, you know, through their future generations. Believe it or not, do your research. Do your research. You know, so, yeah, I mean, that's all it's about, man. You know, and it's a pretty big deal. You know, you like I said, we're going to see a lot more celebrities coming out and saying they're in open relationships or just doing open relationships. If they aren't already, you know what I mean? So that's all I got for y'all. Let me know what you agree, disagree, you know, like, dislike. Of course, if you dislike, leave a comment, let me know so we can have a respectful conversation. You know what I mean? And of course, like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification button so you'll be notified for whatever other videos I upload. Of course, let me know what other topics you want me to talk about. Not just dating relationships, if that's what you want, cool, but also health, wealth, and mindset. I want y'all to be complete people. So let me know what y'all want some work on. You know what I mean? And I'll do my best to give my opinion. Of course, if you find value in this video, donate. Any little bit counts. I appreciate anything that you do donate. But only if you find value. Of course, that's all I got for y'all here today. Till next week, y'all stay safe. Constantly keep on getting better with your women's and then just in life in general. And last but not least, always remember, the strongest man is the happiest man.